August 10th, Saturday, we're at Vizcaya Museum and Gardens for the Twilight Parade. I'm going to give you a little insight of what happens here. It's actually a pretty cool museum, and I'll give you a little bit more information as we go. In our previous video, we visited Charles Deering's estate. Today, we're going to be visiting his brother's home, James Deering's Vizcaya Museum and Gardens. James Deering was a retired millionaire and a bachelor in his early 50s when he undertook the challenge to build an elaborate estate in South Florida. He was afflicted with pernicious anemia, a condition for which doctors recommended sunshine and a warm climate. Vizcaya became the place where he hoped to restore his health. He loved sailing and boating, he owned 3 yachts, and was greatly interested in landscaping and plant conservation. Both hobbies were to play an important role in the design of Vizcaya. The project began modestly, but it grew to become the engrossing pastime of the last years of Deering's life. In this episode, we're going to show you an event that the community put together at the Deering Estate. This event took place at night, so the lighting isn't optimal. But in a future video, we will take a tour of the gardens and the museum. I would like to thank you for joining us in this episode. Please hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't, and please share this video with your friends.
This guy back here.
What is his name? Marcus.
Marcus Magellan. That's the guy right there. And a whole parade of people.
So this is a block party. The parade is gonna go over there.
Right, this is a block party, so we will line up at 8:15, they said?
Yeah.
8:15, and then we're going to walk over to Vizcaya, which is the gardens. And it's just a big parade, and they're going to light it all up.
The community did it.
Yeah, pretty much the community got together, They made a lot of sculptures. A lot of the kids from the community were able to do summer camp here. Today is, what, August 10th?
August 10th, yes.
And Monday is school starting for the kids, right?
No, next Monday.
Next Monday, so summer is almost over. And I guess this is pretty much the finale for them. You know, celebrating everything that they did. What the music. You guys good. You like it?
I like her and I like them.
We got some good video of all. So we'll see you on the parade. Get out of the kitchen, you know how to go for something. Roll my breakfast, I'm a hungry man.
If you have questions or need assistance, there are a bunch of staff wearing white t-shirts with a blue and Vizcaya logo.
We're glad you're here. Let's get started.
For the last 3 years, Vizcaya has invited Processional Art Workshop to conceive and direct an immersive experience that brings the community together through a series of art-making workshops and culminating an illuminated twilight parade that takes over the estate for one spectacular evening. Prior to starting the parade, there's a block party with live music and food. Once the day turns into night, the procession begins towards Vizcaya Museum and Gardens, and we take a nice walk through the village of Vizcaya.
So basically what happens here is that our different pieces of a puzzle, like that's the back of a dragon maybe, and then there's another piece over there, and they all come together.
Where was the head?
The head is all the way over there.
Oh, right there. Back.
Way back there. And that's a fish.
All these sculptures you see here have been created by the community to display in tonight's event.
So back in the times when this was, I guess, the 1920s.
The monkey.
They used to do this at a certain time of the year. All his guests came and they got together during his time. And you know what era that was? The Gilded Era. For all the fancy dresses and all the fancy mysteries around. Everybody came out and got together and danced and played and had fun.
Hello. 100 years ago, Vizcaya's owner James Deering and artistic director Paul Chalfin took multiple journeys to Europe to create Vizcaya's immersive environment, assembling a collection of artifacts and architectural detail that reflect many cultures and time periods. Today's event brings these threads together in a participatory procession of lanterns, sounds, and projections created and performed by locals. The performance was built in a week-long series of public workshops. These are hands-on opportunities for people of all ages and abilities to work closely with Vizcaya's artists. Throughout the week, participants created lanterns inspired and informed by Vizcaya's rich history. Here you can see all the sculptures coming together to create a dragon. The colorful Japanese dragon is part of their culture mythology for hundreds of years, representing balance, freedom, and good luck. It is also known to have supernatural powers and wisdom. Many people choose a dragon that represents balance in their life. If you would like to support our channel, you can check out the description below where you can get apparel, stickers, and mugs. By supporting our channel, it keeps these videos going.